Hello and welcome to dbForge Studio for MySQL tutorial. dbForge Studio for MySQL can help migrate databases between MySQL, MariaDB, Amazon Aurora, or other supported MySQL engines. These migrations can be done within the same database instance or between different instances. There are two ways to migrate databases with dbForge Studio for MySQL. We can use database copy or database backup and restore. In this video, we are going to explore these two options. We are using the latest version of the product, which is dbForge Studio 2019 for MySQL. We are using a freely available MySQL sample database called Sakila for our demo. The Sakila sample database represents a fictitious DVD rental store. We are running this database in an Amazon RDS MySQL instance. This is our source system. Our target system is an Amazon Aurora MySQL instance. To start off, we click on the database menu, then select the copy databases option. This opens the copy databases screen. From the top part of the screen, we select the source connection and then the target connection. We have already created these two connections for our demo. If you haven't created the source or destination connection, you can first create it here. From the source instance, we select the Sakila database. We also select the two checkboxes to include the data and drop the target database if it already exists. Next, we click on the gear icon near the top right corner of the screen. This opens the copy databases settings dialog box. From here, we make sure the disable foreign keys option is selected and lock all tables for read and use a single transaction options are deselected. Once we are happy, we click OK to close the dialog box and then click on the green arrow between the source and the target connections. It turns into a red square. This means the copy operation has started. You can see the progress indicator from the progress column and the time elapsed from the elapsed time column. Once the copy is successful, the progress column shows the message complete. You can also see the database has been created in our target instance. Another way to migrate is to backup the database and then to restore it on the target. To backup a database, we click on the database menu, then choose Backup and Restore from the submenu, and then select the Backup Database option. This opens up the database backup wizard. From here, we select the connection to our source instance. After selecting the connection, we select the database to backup. Here, we have selected the Sakila database from the source instance. Next, we provide the path to the backup folder. We don't have to provide a backup file name. If we don't give a name, dbForge will assign a default one for us. In this case, we are calling our backup file name Sakila. We can also choose to add a date and timestamp at the end of the file name. dbForge Studio for MySQL will create the backup as a SQL script file. Further options allow us to delete the backup after an expiry period, compress it, encrypt it, and protect it with a password. For this exercise, we are leaving these options. We then click Next. In the Backup Content tab, we can choose to backup database structure only, data only, or both structure and data. We can also exclude certain database components from the backup. The default is to include all components and to backup both structure and data. We leave these defaults and then click Next. There are a number of options in the Options tab. We keep all the defaults, then we click Next. The Errors Handling tab allows us to choose how we want to handle any errors during backup. We keep the default options to prompt us when an error occurs, and then click Backup. The Progress tab shows us the progress of the backup. If successful, the Finish tab will show the message Backup Complete. There is also an option to open the script file once the wizard is closed. We keep it unchecked and then click Finish. We are now in the backup folder. You can see dbForge Studio for MySQL has created the SQL script file. Let's say we want to restore this backup to our Amazon Aurora instance. To restore, we click on the database menu, then choose Backup and Restore from the submenu, and then select the Restore Database option. This opens up the Database Restore Wizard screen. From here, we select the connection to our Aurora MySQL instance. If we leave the database field blank, the wizard will restore the database with the same name. We want to restore it under a different name, so we are specifying the new database name as sakila_restored. Next, we select the backup file from the file system and then click Restore. The wizard starts to restore the database and shows the progress. Once it completes successfully, we see the message Database Restore completed successfully. It also shows there were zero errors during the restore. We click Finish to exit the wizard. We can now see the sakila_restored database has been created in the Aurora instance. So this completes our tour of database migration with dbForge Studio for MySQL. We hope you found it useful. With 160 products, Devart is one of the top database companies in the world today. On average, Devart products are downloaded 37,000 times a month. Nearly 60% of the Fortune 100 companies use Devart database tools. To know more about these products, visit the website.